very much, Luca. I think it's happy to share with you the view of our bank and to explain why we are so interested in this initiative in trying to find a concrete solution to energy efficiency in Europe. As a pan-European commercial bank, we are very obviously focused on the well-being of the communities in which we operate. We are very focused in and trying to promote best market practices, and we feel that we have a sense of responsibility towards the societies like the other banks operating in Europe, mainly for two reasons. One is the financing of the real economy, which is obviously of paramount importance in Europe, has always been the case, but nowadays it is even more under current market condition, as well as the focus on environmental conservation. As UniCredit, we are active in both these two fields. In terms of financing to the real economy, we are one of the largest lenders in Europe. We have 25 million of clients. On energy efficiency and energy renewable sources, we are pretty active. Just to drop you a number, at the end of 2016, our exposure towards renewable energy sources was in excess of 9 billion. So we feel that this is our mission, and this is obviously the mission of the financial banking system in Europe, rather than financial banking system in Europe. However, under current market condition, it's becoming much more difficult to continue to play this role. Regulation has become much more, the regulatory framework is much better than a few years ago. Banks are much better capitalized. However, regulation is still a constraint under several perspectives. Banks were in the position to decide which activity to pursue in the last few years. And when I think at our bank, in every decision that we are going to take when thinking at new financial opportunities and initiatives, we always think at regulatory uncertainty and the regulatory framework. This is even true also nowadays after a few years of new regulation coming into place. So the right balance between the regulation and the ability of banks to support the real economy is very, very important. And from that perspective, we appreciate all the efforts made so far by the European Commission in order to promote initiatives to foster financing to the real economy, like, for example, the Capital Markets Union. We appreciate also that in the mid-term review of the Capital Markets Union published yesterday, there is a clear reference to the intention of the Commission to strengthen their leadership on sustainable investments. We are pretty active already in the capital markets. We are one of, we have, like other banks in Europe, a leadership position also on sustainable investment. We have been talking about green bonds. We were the lead manager of the first transaction of the EIB back in 2007, and we continue to be very active on that market. In 2016, for example, we participated as a joint book runner or joint lead manager in 10 transactions for a total placement in excess of 7 billion. So we are really present and we are very keen to move forward also in a new initiative. When thinking at the energy efficiency mortgages, we see that although we see that there is in general, an increase in demand for green products, market players need an incentive to cope with the fragmentation of the market to create a liquid standard, a liquid product in the market. That's why at the beginning of our journey within this initiative, we discussed the possibility to have a different capital treatment for this type of product, obviously if this is justified by the underlying credit quality. Incentives can be different, obviously. This is, was one of the examples, but I'm really glad that now we are thinking and together speaking the same language about ammunition and incentives, because I think that this is really a key aspect for the success of the initiative.
Thank you.